All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I'm going to give all praises, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahweh, Ba'ashem Kodash, Rabbi Thumb. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, their Ruel, and a salute, and a Shalom to all the Akim that are out here laboring, pushing this truth, in all sincerity and in truth. This is going to be a lesson of comfort, right? Of comfort in Abarataza. Strengthen you brothers' faith, all right? This is Romans 8. Romans 8 and 18. All right? Hold on real quick. Right, this is Romans 8 and 18. It says this: For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. Right? So what we are are suffering right now and are going to suffer real soon, that cannot be compared to the blessing that we're going to get, okay? Because that blessing is what man? The kingdom, man. All right, man, that blessing is the kingdom, right? That inheritance is the kingdom, right? Let's get this. Matthew 5 and 11 to 12, it says, Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Right? So when we are being evil spoken of, when we are being hated and persecuted, man, we are blessed. Right? Because in I think it's in the book of Luke. It says, Woe unto you when men shall speak well of you, right? So if everyone is speaking well of you, that's not good, man. You're not doing something good. Okay? This is verse 12. It says, Rejoice and be exceeding glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. Right? So the prophets were persecuted back then. So guess what, man? We will be persecuted again in this time. All right? Let's see real quick. None of these things. Akan. Let's get, this is Acts 20. And 23. No, 22 says, And now, behold, I go bound in the spirit unto Jerusalem, and not knowing the things that shall befall me there, right? Save that the Holy Spirit witnesseth in every city, saying that bonds and afflictions abide me. But none of these things move me, and neither count I my life dear unto myself, so that I might finish my course with joy in the ministry which I have received of Yahweh Ba'ashem El Shah. right? Which I have received of the Lord Yahweh Shai, right? To testify the gospel, right? To testify the gospel of the grace of Yahweh, right? So, all of these things that we are suffering, man, it's not moving us, man. It's not moving us, man. All right, man, we are constantly getting stronger and stronger and stronger, man. Each and every day, man. Okay? Because suffering and going through shit for the greatest blessing and greatest inheritance on this earth, man, it's worth it, man. It's worth it. Suffering, being persecuted, and dying for the testimony and the gospel of Yahweh Basha, of Yahweh and Yahweh Shah. It's worth it, man. It's worth it. Why? Because we're going to live forever, man. Right? Jake, we're going to live forever, man. See, hold on real quick. Let's go back. This is 2 Corinthians 4:17. It says, "For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory." Right? So our light affliction is only for a moment, man. It is only for a moment. It ain't forever, man. It's only for a moment. Right? Say, verse 18, "While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not. For the things which are seen are temporal." Right? So Babylon of the great is temporal, right? Esau, Edom, he's temporal. Okay? Wickedness is temporal. Right? They say, "But the things which are not seen are eternal." So what's eternal, man? The kingdom. Righteousness, man. That's eternal, man. That's forever. That's everlasting. All right, man. All right, man. The rulership of Jacob, that's forever. Okay? Let's get this. Hebrews 11:25. "Choosing rather to," it's like it says, "choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of Yahweh than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season." Right? So Moses, he chose to suffer affliction with his people, man. Right? Instead of enjoying the pleasures of sin for a season. Why? Because Moses knew that suffering with his people has a better profit in the end, man. Let's get 1 Peter 1:6. What the hell? It say 1 Peter 1:6 says, "Wherein ye greatly rejoice, though for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through manifold temptations." Right? Says that the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Yahweh Shah Mashiach. Right? So our faith is constantly being tested. Right, man? And the ultimate testing of our faith is the hour of temptation, man. Okay? And right, and what did Hamashiach say? This is what Yahweh Shah said. It says this. Revelation 2 and 10. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, it says, the devil shall cast some of you into prison that ye may be tried. And ye shall have the tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. Right? Be faithful, right? Unto death. Let's get the word faithful in the Greek. Faithful is pistos, I guess.
Strong's G, 4103, pistos. Pistos.
All right, so the word for faithful in the Greek is pistos, right? It says trusty, faithful, right? Of persons who show themselves faithful in the transaction of business, right? Blah, blah, blah. One who kept his plight con, who kept his plighted faith worthy of trust, that can be relied on. Believing, confiding, trusting. In the New Testament, one who trusts in Yahweh's promises. Wow. It says one who has become convinced that Yahweh Shai is the Messiah and author of salvation. Wow. Wow. Let's get a few more. Close out. Let's see. Well, let's get one more. This is one of my favorite. This is one of my favorite scriptures. Psalms 30. Right? Psalms 30 and 5. It says, for his anger endureth but for a moment, and his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning, right? Now, joy cometh in the morning. That's what, man? That's when Yahweh Shai Mashiach makes his return, man. And we are, all right, man, and we are redeemed and delivered from the hands of Esau. Right, from captivity, man. It says, well, his anger endureth but a moment, and his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning, right? So we are weeping right now. But Yahweh Shai Mashiach, he's about to make his return, man. And we will be delivered, man. We will be and we will be redeemed and delivered. So Yahweh Shai, he's on his way, man. Yes, man. Yahweh Shai is coming back. So with that, I say Shalom.